is one man that continues the work on the Nexus 7. The Nexus 7 Wi-Fi grouper and tilapia. Tilapia is the same model, but then with 3G. Welcome to a new tutorial here at Channel 48. Today I'm here with the grouper. This is the 7-inch grouper that was created in 2012. It's a pretty good tablet, really. It's pretty good, nothing wrong with it, but it's outdated. So I will have a link in my description showing you how to install TWRP onto this device. I would go for the latest, by the way, because the video was a while ago. So I have an old TWRP 2.7.7 installed on this tablet, and I'm gonna show you how to install the latest upgraded ROM with security patches from May this year onto this device. Main developer that is making sure that this device is still running and up even in 2019 is nobody else than Andy Sa. Andy Sa is a developer that is creating OTA updates for this device. These are zip files from 220 megabytes that as well contain the operating system. Now, in this video, I'm gonna show you how you can do a clean install. A clean install that will include you to have a working OTG. Problem is, if you're gonna wipe the complete tablet the way I did, then suddenly you will be out of OTG. You won't be able to connect to the computer anymore, and there is no SD card slot in here, so it's kind of tricky. Okay, if you want to do it a good way, if you want to do a clean install on this device, meaning wiping the internal storage, wiping all the traces of the previous Androids, you know, and install a brand new Android on the device, then there is a trick. A trick how you can still be on the latest AOSP ROM from Andy Sa with working OTG. So that's what I'm going to show you in this video. You will need two ROMs. And I think that any ROM that you had before, if you did this before, that has working OTG available in the device after install, you could use. Okay, I'm using the AOSP Extended. So what is the procedure? If you already have TWRP installed on the device and you made a backup and you want to do a full clean install, so the thing will only run that operating system that you install, then you will need an OTG hub. Okay, it's mandatory, because there's no other way how you're gonna get these files, you know, installed on the tablet. So that's what I'm gonna show you in this video. I did everything already. I wiped the drive already, and I run into problems, not being able to. I was like, hey, what's going on? But I found a solution, and that solution I'm gonna show you in this video. So let's get started. Okay, there we are with the tablet. We're gonna just reboot the tablet. Okay. And while rebooting it, I'm gonna hold down the volume and the power at the same time until we see a little Android, and then we're gonna hit volume up 1, 2, and we're gonna hit power to go into a recovery mode. You will find out that I have TWRP 2.7 installed, 2.711 I think it is, and here it is. Yes, and what we're gonna do, we're gonna do advanced wipe, data cache, system Dalvik. Okay, if you already had some good working ROM with working OTG, then in fact I would not wipe the internal storage. Only wipe the internal storage if you also have a little device like this. This is an OTG hub. Okay, if you don't have this thing, don't wipe the internal storage. All right, just do a Dalvik catch, system catch. If you're already on AOSP, you don't even have to wipe any of this. just flash the rum on top of it. Okay, but I'm gonna do a kind of clean install. So I'm gonna show you the procedure. So let's just imagine that we wipe the internal drive. Okay, and we have this little OTG hanging to the thing. Then we will be able to install from USB as well. We will be able to select the USB OTG, but now it's not connected. And you know, I have the files on my internal, so I'm gonna use those. Then you're gonna hit OK. So the first ROM that you will have to install is a good working ROM that had a working OTG. This one, the AEX ROM for Grouper, I know it's a good ROM. It's as well a USB, as you can see. So I found a nice little trick that I am gonna share with you. Because in fact now I'm not installing the latest ROM, I'm installing a ROM from 2017, September 18, blah blah blah, 2017. Okay, and soon you're gonna understand why I'm doing this. Now it's very important, yeah, that you boot this system one time and then verify if everything works. Okay, so we just installed this ROM. We ain't gonna do nothing more. We're just gonna reboot and hit don't install SuperSU, because we're gonna root in a different way, and we're just gonna let the thing boot. You're gonna see that this is a minimalistic version of Android. It's only 220 megabytes, very very light. It does not even contain a browser or anything like that. Although the AEX should contain all these things, all these extra applications. So yeah, beautiful, eh? See that? Very nice boot animation. Lovely. Very lovely. Now you have some more things. You have a sound recorder, you have via browser, that's very good, it's very good browser. You have a camera, and let me see if the camera works. You have a decent camera, you see that? Works fine. So this is as well a good ROM. Only thing problem with this ROM is, yeah, the security updates, they are not fully updated. You see? These are security patches from 2017, but this is a perfect ROM, and this ROM will fix the other ROM, because the other ROM, whenever you're gonna install it, won't have no OTG support. Now when we connect the tablet to the USB, we're gonna check that. It immediately asks us, what would you like to do? I want to transfer files. So let's log in into my Flight Simulator 2 OS that I just created. It's coming up very soon, peeps. Nexus 7, internal storage, and there you see the storage, everything is there. Okay, there are the files. So now I have to do something. Okay, welcome really back. Fast. So what we're gonna do now, guys, is we're gonna go back into the recovery. Yeah, and we have everything working now. OTG is working, etc. Camera works, and now we're gonna do something that will as well make that we're gonna lose some of these applications. Although I'm not even sure. Let's see what's gonna happen. We're gonna reboot it, restart, and now we can select recovery. You see that? That is in this ROM. This IX ROM is very handy. It has this little menu, and in USP I could not find that that setting in developers options. Maybe it's somewhere else. So what we now gonna do is we're just gonna install on top of this ROM, we're gonna install the latest ROM from Andisa. Okay, the 7.12 without a wipe. It's now as well installing the security patches, and we're almost there. Successful, and now we're gonna reboot the system again. We're gonna say do not install. And now the IX boot animation will be gone. We will only see an Android booting up. See that? So I'm gonna let this boot, otherwise this video is gonna get too long, and then I'm gonna get back to you. Alright? Okay, there we are, madame and monsieur. And let's see what we got now. Okay. Boom, and all the other apps are gone. But now we have a working OTG on this ROM. Charging, transfer files, Nexus 7, and there you go. You see that? Everything works. So the OTG works now, and that's really fantastic. But now you still don't have anything. This is all you will have. Now, if you are smart, then you will download some of these applications. You know, if you want to be independent, if you don't want to install no gaps, or you could also say, hey, wait a minute, you created a mod. I'm gonna install your mod. Well, you are allowed to do that. Volume down, power, keep holding. We go back into a recovery. And there we are. Yeah, and now we're gonna install my Mac IO S mod. Okay, it's a mod containing all my applications, including look and feels, and in fact it makes a sort of unofficial themed Mac tablet from this thing. Okay, we are still not rooted, eh? I did not root the device yet. I will look for my Magi 616, I think. And I will use that. Okay, so now you're gonna see an old fashioned Apple. This is kinda these logos you find on MacBooks. You see that? And also nice and small, not big as on the iPad mini. I think Apple did not such a nice job on that one. The Apple Mini has real big boot animation, doesn't look good. Device is too small. So now we're gonna go for launch share, and we say always. And there we are, boom. Coolest of launch share, of course, is that it's very customizable. In Team
You can select any icon pack you wish. I have two icon packs in here, my iOS icon pack and my own Mac OS kinda Linux icon pack that I created for my mods. We can say dark, nice dark theme. Okay, in the desktop we're gonna hide the pixel bar and number of icons is okay. We're gonna scale the icons to be a little bit bigger. We're gonna scale them to 115%. Okay, the dock, same thing. Dock, I'm gonna scale up to 115%. Okay, but you can do your own thing. All right, the app drawer, I'm gonna set the drawer opacity to about 50%, 55% is good. And the icons, I'm gonna make them just slightly smaller, 96%. So now we're gonna have this. It's gonna make up the theme, boom. And there we are, and I have all my icons. The coolest of this is icons that are not, fitting too good. Long press, edit, hit the icon itself. And there you're gonna find some icons. I'm gonna go for that one, but you could also go look for another icon in the icon packs. You could also go in this icon pack and then choose the icon from here. But I think I have no microphone icon yet in here. This thing is not, this is in alpha state, okay? It's, yeah. I just started doing these kinds of things. And the APK Pure Store, for instance, we can edit that icon and give it, for instance, the App Store icon, you know? Because this thing is themed in the style of Mac. The Magis Manager also got another icon, but it should not. It should use the original icon, because it fits fantastic with this theme, etc., etc. So that's how you can change things around. You see that? And in fact, yeah, this is my favorite setup. Okay, and I will just set up some apps like that. This one can go. No need to have two app stores on my desktop, right? So yeah, this one can go there. And let me see, what do I have more in here? Screencast, I can cast to my computer. I can see who's on my Wi-Fi. We have an ultra firewall built in, okay? But you will have to gain root for that. As you can see, Radio Droid is as well available. Podcast. The Radio Droid icon, I have a better one for that. We can go into my Mac icon pack and I'm gonna go for this one. You see that? Now we have two different icons. Looks better. See? And we also have root browser. The root browser is as well installed. This is why I use it very frequently. So it can be on the desktop. And there it is. This is my ROM. And at least this is my setup. This is my kind of ROM. The ROM that I want for my device. Okay. This is, of course, the ROM by our friend called... Yeah, in fact, it was made by many people. But the man that is working on this ROM, that is Mr. Andy Sa. Now, Andy Sa means, in my language, Andy's sister. Andy Sa. So yeah, the other day we had a review of the 10.1 tablet from Samsung. The Espresso Wi-Fi by Andy. And today, in fact, I'm showing another ROM of another device, and this one was by Andy Sa. So I don't know who the Sa is, but one thing I know for sure, these guys, both names are Andy. So Andy, great job and very nice work. I'm very happy that I found the solution of how to, you know, get this thing to work properly. And I think this is it, guys. What more can I show? Yeah, the only thing that you must do now is connect to the internet. Yeah, and then you go to the application store, the APK Pure store, and then you just go get a browser. I would go for Firefox or for Chrome. You know, most of the times when I push these browsers in, they don't work, and then you know, they kind of embarrass me. I make a video and then I show the mod, and then I get errors. I hate it when I when an app gives me any error. I don't use these things anymore, apps that give me error. So that's why, maybe I will keep looking for a browser that I can still push into my mod and that will actually work. Firefox is not working, Via is not working, the browser from Linux OS is not working when I push it in. So yeah, but hey, you have an application store, so you can go ahead and get your own browser and anything that you need, you can go get it yourself. And I see that I must go ahead and talk to somebody here, and that's it. I say back to the studio.
Okay, that's about it. It's kind of getting dark. It's food time now. So, I want to thank you for watching. Remember that it's very mandatory if you're gonna do a clean install, if you're gonna wipe the internal storage, that you have a OTG hub. Don't let it happen to you. Otherwise, your tablet's gonna sit there and there won't be anything that you can do for it. Okay? So, credits as well to the AEX team that created the old ROM that I installed as the first ROM. I will host that one on my Google Drive, just in case, you know, if you need it. That is a good working ROM and it has all the necessary elements on board to, you know, let the OTA ROM run good, and you know, you will have OTG connection to your computer. Because if you don't do that, then if you're just gonna install the OTA alone, as standalone, and then gonna build your Android on top of that, you're gonna find out that your OTG is not working at a certain moment, and I'm not sure how to fix that. So yeah, this was my method, you know, and as you can see, it works fine. My tablet is up and running, having the latest security patches from May 2019. And that for a tablet of 2012. I say thumbs up, guys, there at XDA. Once again, you, thank you for watching. If you think this information was useful, leave this video a thumbs up. Of course, subscribe to my channel, not forgetting to hit the notification bell as well. You know, I set it to all, so you at least will be updated when I upload a new video again here on YouTube.